That's perfect. I have not abandoned myself. What you find in the street is amazing. This shutter here, the color that's been weathered, and the blue and the yellow. But what really interests me is this combination of symmetry and asymmetrical deformation. That's a very good question. Why am I an artist? Actually, I was a janitor for about 2 years, and I really didn't like it. I mean, it was interesting to make things clean. I worked in a boatyard for many, many years, underneath the bottoms of boats, scraping away the barnacles and the paint, and didn't like that either. Then I was in advertising for many years. Chasing money. I didn't like that either.
J'ai rencontré en fait Steve Beck par l'intermédiaire d'une amie qui est également artiste peintre, qui m'a dit que elle avait un copain qui venait des États-Unis, peintre reconnu, et qui essayait de pouvoir créer son réseau à Lyon. Et un jour, ils sont venus tous les deux, ils ont regardé effectivement notre univers pictural, le choix des artistes qu'on avait ici. Puis ils ont dit, est-ce qu'on peut postuler? J'ai dit, oui, tout à fait. Ce que fait Steve Beck correspond bien à l'esprit de la galerie. Et il a passé son étape, il a été sélectionné, et c'est comme ça qu'il est arrivé chez nous. Steve Beck, en tant que personne qui arrivait sur Lyon, est allé s'installer directement. En fait, pas s'installer directement, en tout cas, il a demandé effectivement à dire, moi, je veux aussi présenter mon travail aux Lyonnais. Et il s'est inscrit au marché de la création.
Hey William.
Et à partir de là, il a pu aussi rencontrer des gens et avoir des contacts directs avec le public lyonnais, avec les touristes, avec tout ce monde-là.
There used to be a long rail here, and they cut it up to do some construction. So I use what's on the street.
Et je sais qu'il a déjà, par le retour de clients, qu'effectivement, il a été repéré également sur le marché de la création.
See how it all shakes out at the end of the day. I just keep making my work. And I make the work that I want to make, how I want to make it. And, you know, you can take it from there. Or not. Exhibition and I was milling around, I was moving about, and I overheard a guy saying, "Whoa, my dog could have painted that." And at first I thought, it's offensive, but then I realized this is an opportunity. So I went up to him and I asked him, "How much for your dog? Because, you know, I'll buy your dog. Are you kidding? This is great. I'll stop painting and, you know, I give my new dog, my new artist, a few bowls of kibbles every now and then, and I've got a factory."
Du coup, le projet de Steve, effectivement, le parti pris sur le migrant et l'immigrant, je trouve ça très intéressant. Dans l'idée, pas facile, par les temps qui courent aujourd'hui, mais je trouve qu'effectivement, c'est une belle idée à développer. On a tous, à un moment ou à un autre, dans nos familles, des gens qui viennent d'ailleurs.
It's kind of cool over here. Yeah, there's something about... the ones that I want to put out today, I want there to be a surrounding of kind of interest, like places where tourists would go, but where they won't notice something out of context. It's hard to explain. But you see, it's kind of interesting over there. Well, I'll go down the stairs and put the other one on that wall there. That to me is like, I'm looking for places that the homeless, the people without shelter might go to hide themselves from people. I thought, wouldn't it be extraordinary? Wouldn't it be incredibly interesting if a work of art is placed out of context in a street? Somewhere under a bridge, and it gets noticed. The painting gets noticed before the people. Ooh. 45 degrees north, 76.735 minutes east, 04.82750. There it is. I haven't come here just to take a few moments for myself, and it's a beautiful view, it's quiet. Over there's some Roman arches that have been filled in for some reason. I've always found that interesting. Why do they fill in the arches? I don't know. Modernity, it's moving forward in time, but erasing the past, it's all very interesting. And see, that's a lot about what I'm doing here. Where are we in space and time? And also, for me, these paintings are an extension of myself, and where would I go to feel comfortable? And that's why I chose this plot. I feel comfortable here. I feel relaxed. And over there, there's an old half-ruined wall, and this painting just feels right to go over there. hopefully it will represent this whole movement of people through time. That's what I'm trying to represent here. In some ways, it's all about the migration of people. People moving through space and time. This is an incredible spot for this painting. It's perfect. And it's this consistent truth throughout this whole thing. It's, I have not abandoned myself. The painting is abandoned a little. Now I hope it finds a new home. And that explains the note, I have not abandoned myself, because the painting has not abandoned itself. It is part of me, and it will always go on. So where do I put this note? I put it like that. I do have to suffer a little. I have to put my best work out on the street. I have to feel this whole process to try to imagine what it's like to give up everything to find a better life and then still end up on the street. These immigrants, these people migrating, have given up everything to, in this case, come here to France. And still, they're on the street. Their life hasn't really improved. So I'm putting this work out on the street to feel the same thing. Or try anyway. And hopefully people will notice this and just give an extra seconds of thought, an extra second of thought about who we are all surrounded by. Who are these people? I walk away.
You ready?
Just a minute. Need the nails. Keep it running. Oh, that's really cool. I need some more tape. I knew this tape was a waste of my money. That's good. Oh, that's really good. Heck, that's beautiful. Oh yeah, it keeps moving. I have not abandoned myself. That's really, really, really good. Okay, I like that. All right. Say goodbye. And literally walk away. Just walk away. I was talking to somebody, a guy named Camille, as a matter of fact. I was talking to him about, should you protect them? Should you worry about them if it rains and snows? And yeah, but I'm not going to. Because nobody is thinking about, the poor guy in torn clothes. Nobody's really worried about where he's going to sleep that night. A perfect day and a perfect place. Oh, I love that. Straight? Like that. Experiment continues. Say goodbye. At the hospital here, I've got some skin cancers, one on my nose. You might be able to see this scar here. That's because there's the skin cancer. They cut in the wrong place the first time, which is okay. You know, shit happens, right? It's one thing to make an abstract painting, it's another thing to make an abstract work out of a person's face. But, anyway. That's it. Time to get cut. See you later. Knife fight in Madrid. Why Madrid, huh? What was I doing in Madrid? That's the question. I feel great. I feel fantastic. I feel like somebody.
Without cancer?
I feel like somebody just cut my nose.
You gotta be careful with this stuff.
I don't recommend you try this at home. Just for professionals only. It's fucking incredible. You can't duplicate that. You can't sit here with a brush and make that. It's just impossible.
Moi, je dis de Steve que son travail, c'est un moment de vie vu à des millions et des millions de kilomètres d'ici. Et il a un jeu de couleurs très sensible. Il est beaucoup dans la matière. Il a des contrastes, notamment une force très vive dans ces bleus qu'il utilise. Et du coup, il nous fait rentrer dans ce monde dans lequel on a souvent la tête dans le guidon. Et là, non, il permet d'avoir du recul au travers de la peinture.
So the ochre turns to a brown earth color. It's really amazing.
I think you could say that that's the underlying concept of all my work, is giving a temporary permanence to the intangible. But I gotta work fast now. Thank you. By painting these shadows, I'm giving them a temporary permanence. Well, that's a damn good question. What is the truth? What you remember from, you know, 5 minutes ago will be totally different than what I remember from 5 minutes ago, but we just went through it. What is the truth? Making a piece of art? In fact, as artists, we're just making illusions. When I first started thinking about doing this, I thought, well, I'll just put a few things on the street. I'll try to sell everything that I can first. I'll just make a minor statement, kind of like playing a minor chord on a piano. And I remember the story of Robert Rauschenberg, and his thing of erasing a de Kooning drawing. I guess what I'm doing, in many ways, is I'm erasing a Rauschenberg. Line is, though, I mean, any given Sunday I probably see 700 people, sometimes more, and you know what, if they just see my work or everybody else's work just out of the corner of their eye, at least it's something. Hey, Ronnie.
Yeah.
The crowd that comes here to the Marché, the kind of people that they are, honestly, a lot of them are taking a long walk on a Sunday with their children and their dogs. And they like to look at some art, which is fine. There's the people that are looking just to decorate their homes. Nothing wrong with that. There's the people that are actually looking to collect real art. It's a really interesting mixed group that comes here. The artists here in general make a living. To leave, but I can't take my work with me. So I try to use it in a way to maybe touch a few people's sensitivity about the plight of the immigrant. I'm an immigrant here. You know, I'm just trying to run away from the shadow. Trying to make something positive out of something that has been horribly negative. And yet, I have zero regrets, for my time here has been incredible and fantastic. I've met some great people. I fell in love with an incredibly wonderful woman. And it's terrible to have to leave. But I have to go. Everything, like this train station, everybody here is in some kind of transit. We're all moving, we're all crawling, we're running, we're flying. It's an amazing experience to put this here. Fantastic, fantastic. With abstraction, it's like you have to take all of art history as if it were water in a swimming pool, and then you have to just slowly immerse yourself into it, little by little, and feel it until it's over your head. And how long can you hold your breath? And that's going to give you the beginning of understanding what it's like to be underwater. Because that's kind of what abstraction is like. It's just you're in it. You're surrounded by it. It's incredible. Been a rich symbol of transit in motion, but not just a linear motion or a horizontal motion, but a vertical one. It's really cool. This is what I understand to be the place called the 400 Stairs. Wow, that's absolutely beautiful. It's beautiful. Wow. You know what? That's perfect. You know, the work that I'm putting out in the street, it's, of course, it's abstract. What I'm doing is abstract. I'm putting puzzle pieces out in the street, but I'm not going to put the puzzle together for you. Hopefully you'll have your own idea of what this all means. Now this thing's really starting to get interesting to me because I put a painting there the other day, and pretty much in a few days it was gone. And this is not an easy spot for people to get at. They gotta jump over a fence. It's steep, it's slippery, it's not easy. So I
then I started thinking about this, and I started noticing that these paintings are virtually disappearing almost as fast as I put them out there. And I'm starting to wonder, what does that mean? This whole process is starting to add more questions than answers.
Steve est donc un artiste peintre américain qui est venu dans nos cours de français, c'est ainsi que nous l'avons connu. Et depuis quelque temps, il fait une expérience où il disperse ses tableaux à l'intérieur de la ville, particulièrement de la Croix-Rousse, pour voir la réaction des spectateurs, de son art. Au démarrage, je pense qu'il a eu effectivement une action de curiosité. Il a éveillé la curiosité parmi les personnes qui passaient et qui récupéraient ses toiles. Peut-être que l'on peut se poser une question, maintenant que cette action est assez efficace et que la dispersion est réelle, est-ce que les personnes ne se sont pas renseignées, puisqu'il a laissé ses adresses, sur qui est Steve Beck ? Que fait-il ? D'où vient-il ? Quelle est la valeur de ses toiles, aussi bien artistique que financière ?
J'ai vu un tableau en deux parties, dans le profil du paysage. Trois jours après, j'ai vu qu'il n'y avait plus rien. J'ai continué à courir dans le parc et à un moment donné, vous avez une petite grotte qui sert pour les enfants à s'amuser et j'ai vu la moitié. J'ai vu un grand carton d'abord et en fait, en m'approchant, j'ai reconnu le tableau. La nuit était en train de tomber, il y avait de la boue dessus et je me suis dit, qu'est-ce que je fais ? J'ai ramassé le tableau, la nuit était en train de tomber, sous la pluie, et je l'ai ramené à la maison, qui est assez extraordinaire, parce que ce n'est pas tous les jours qu'on retrouve des œuvres d'un peintre.
So now, I'm starting to wonder, have I called any attention to the human condition of migration? Or have I just ended up decorating a few living rooms? And then, of course, I asked myself, does it matter? Or I did what I needed to do. This painting is simply flag, red, white, and blue, the color of the American flag, the colors of the French flag, and ironically, the color of the Russian flag. The predominant red is the crushed icon of consumerism, Coke. Combining objects that I found in the street, it goes back to the street. What does that mean to you? You figure it out. Extraordinary there. That's perfect. I really like that. I feel very comfortable there. Back to another place where one of them has been taken, gone. Colors here. This is an abstract painting by itself. It's beautiful. Where
where should this particular thing find a temporary home?
This is really a cool place.
Really incredible. Longitude, latitude, east 005.04440. Le Pont Lafayette.
Feels good there. I feel good there. Two days later, and these two are still here, and that's a good thing, because one of the initial ideas I had here was making a statement about the transient nature of humanity. You know, everything is temporal, everything is temporary. And it's kind of ironic that I don't feel I'm making this statement, because I put them on the wall, put them out in the street, and they're gone in a couple of hours. A little ironic.
A little crooked.
Another one. Still on the wall. Now it's getting interesting.
And yet this one, I don't know, I think we're talking about 2 months. And this one's still here. I really like that. What a contrast. Fascinating.
It's come to my attention. Someone has tried to contact me by putting a note on one of my paintings. And I must admit it goes against my instincts to respond. Because from the very beginning the concept was to walk away from these paintings, like as if they were my children, and I put them out and I walk away. And I'm thinking to myself, if I was an immigrant, I had left everything behind and I came to a new place and I felt isolated and felt alone, I would really welcome contact. So I've been contacted here, and I've read it, and I've written a reply, and I think I'll go answer the guy.
I was walking with a friend from Canada. She had never seen the museum before. And we saw the art, and there was, you know, a little can with a scroll in it, a paper. So we looked at the painting, and then we opened the scroll, and there was the note. And I thought the note was really nice, because, you know, it gave meaning to the painting. At the same time, you didn't have to look at it. I think it was about, you know, immigrants. It was a statement saying that you can pretend it's not here, the art is not here, just like people pretend immigrants are not here. Which is what I really liked about it. You know, it created kind of articulation between the note and the art. You have to look at the note to understand what it's really about, and it's the same thing. If you don't look at it, you don't see it. Wait, people just took them?
Yeah.
What? I you know, I didn't think about taking it. I just thought, you know, it's here for everyone, I guess.
I actually thought this painting in the tunnel would last quite a while, because it's in a car tunnel. You can't walk in here. It's dangerous. I'm back here to this location in an abandoned cathedral, because this piece, in fact, is very relevant. The symbols in this piece communicate a lot about what I'm trying to say with this particular location. In this piece, and the reason why we're here at the Savannah Cathedral, the block of concrete is suspended in motion, kind of in a way as if a wrecking ball. And the concrete here, for me, symbolizes both construction and destruction. Okay, the green signifies, the green earth, the blue the sky. But it's a little more complicated than that for me because I had originally painted the entire thing blue, knowing that I wanted to cover it all up. So I covered it, and I scraped and I scraped, and I just left a little bit, as if the wall was obscuring the sky. The open sky no longer exists. We were building walls that cover it up. And I don't know whether you can see, but there's traces of blue that are as if being squeezed from the back. It's like this wall is holding back the sky, and the blue is being squeezed through there, and you see little bits of it like kind of leaking out and dripping over the top. You know, these symbols are rather simple, but that's the idea. I want to signify something complex with the most simplistic way I can. This finishing touch, voila, and seeing as how I've lately been in the mood to explain a little of some of the symbols that I use, is the broom. It's kind of a wink of an eye at the people that think that all contemporary art is kind of meaningless. It's thrown together, the sweepings of detritus thrown onto a canvas. And also a little bit of a wink to the people that believe abstract painting could be done by a monkey with, say, a broom. Oh, and most importantly, in this particular painting, the blue. Colors usually have a great signification. The blue in this painting means absolutely nothing. It means that I like blue. In considering where I put these paintings, I'm trying to make the place relevant to the work relevant to the place. To tie all this in together, I'm going to put it over there where there is a series of arches, which to me look like shrines. That's extraordinary. I found this old iron hook. Might have been there for 100 years. And it's the perfect place to hang this. A beautiful day at the Marché, sunny, beautiful, lots of people. Today, this Sunday, we decided to mix some work together, some hyper-realistic work with my abstract work, and kind of gives the overall impression of everything coming together. And it's spring in France, beautiful day, everything just keeps moving. Getting towards the very end of this whole process of putting the paintings out on the street, I'm at the end of it, and I wanted to come back here to one of the first places I showed my work. This is Saint-Cyr au Mont d'Or. I want to come back here to leave what might be the last painting. And it's a very special work because it was given to me by a very, very talented, profoundly talented artist. So she gave me this Chinese ink rendering of a sardine can, and it took me a long time to figure out how to collaborate with her. Yeah, this is one big gigantic painting that I'm making. You know, I'm taking pieces of a puzzle. I'm taking a puzzle and I'm cutting it up and I'm scattering the pieces throughout the city of Lyon. Why Lyon? Because this happens to be where I live right now. I don't know, tomorrow it might be Rome or Madrid. Life is a big fucking puzzle. Very puzzling.